Hey, Jeff Hansen here with Alta Labs, and today we are going to show you a video on how to do the dynamic DNS client on Route 10. So each Route 10 has a dynamic DNS client already built into it that uses the Alta dynamic DDNS, and you can see that if you go to hover over the IP address of your Route 10, you can see what that is. That's automatic. There's nothing you have to do to set that up. It has some cool features as well, so if you want to access the first WAN, you do one dot and then the rest of this for WAN 1. First WAN 2, you would use two dot and then this host name, and that would give you the IP address of the second WAN. So that's all automatic, and you don't have to do anything to set those up. Now, you may already be using a DNS service, or you may have domains that are hosted with Cloudflare or other DNS providers that you want to update. And so in that case, you would want to use our dynamic DNS third-party client that's on the Route 10. So to get that, you go to the, there's two ways to get there. You can either get there with your Route 10, go to the WAN port and edit WAN 1, whatever WAN you're using on your Route 10. So that's one way to get to it. Another way that's super easy is you go to Settings, Networks, WANs, and you choose the WAN. And this is associated with the WAN that you're connected to. So for example, if your WAN 1 connects and gets an IP address, then it's going to go ahead and register the IP address that it gets with your DNS provider at that time. Same thing with WAN 2. So if you set it up on WAN 2, then it would go ahead and set it up with that provider on that one. So if you have multiple providers or multiple host names that you need to set up per WAN, you would need to set this up on each WAN, not just one of them. So we're going to go ahead and set this up on WAN 1 on this Route 10. To do that, you go to the advanced, the very bottom here, we have dynamic DNS. And so when this WAN connection gets a connection, it will set up its DNS. We are going to set up no IP first. We just wanted to go through and give a couple of examples of really common providers and how they work. So this is no IP. And we have in our help, our help.alta.inc, in our knowledge base, we have a whole bunch of, we've tested this with a whole bunch of different providers, and we have kind of some hints on what you need to use for your username and password, whether that be the string bearer or an API key or different things like that. So each one has different quirks, and we tried to document that all right here just so that you can tell very easily what you need to enter into those different DNS providers to get it working with that specific provider. So we're going to try no IP first. This is a brand new no IP account, and I'm going to go ahead and set up my first host name. We'll call it Route 10 Speeds, and you have to pick a domain name. So no IP provides a whole bunch of ones for free, so I'm just going to pick DDNS.net. It automatically populates the IP address that you're coming from, and then we're going to go ahead and create it with a DDNS key. Now you want to create it with a key so that you can copy and paste that key into the DNS client in Route 10. So we know that our host name is this, so we're going to set that up as the host name. Okay, so I copied and pasted that, and we generate a key in no IP. We copy the username, and then we copy the password. Okay, so it's as simple as that. Then you hit save. And then we're going to go to our terminal and double check that it actually is resolving. So I have this already set up here. The fastest way to check it is to check with the name server of the provider that you're using. So you can do a host name check or a name server check on the domain that you're resolving against. And we see that for no IP, these are their name servers. NF12345.noip.com. Okay. So if I check with that server, it will it gets update the fastest, right? Because as DNS works through the internet, there's time to live values and things like that that make it get cached. But since we're updating dynamically, we want to make sure that it actually updates immediately so we can double check it. So in this case, I'm doing a lookup. I look up my hostname, route10speeds.ddns.net, and that is the correct WAN IP address. Now, I happen to know that this is a WAN IP address that is behind another Route10, so it's not publicly on the internet. So this may or may not be useful, right? We have an option in Route10, the DNS client, where you can actually specify, instead of registering the WAN IP address of the physical IP address on that connection, you can actually register the public WAN IP. So this would be usually a lot more useful, right? So if you're behind a NAT, you would want to make sure you check this box so that it gives you the IP address of your public IP address so you can reach it directly. So I'm going to do that now, and I'm going to save, and then we'll give that a minute. Depending on the DNS provider, it can take anywhere from 30 to 60 seconds. So we'll check that out. Looks like it hasn't been updated yet. You can also go to the No IP website and just refresh. So if we refresh, you can see that it's already been updated on the website, but it hasn't been updated on the DNS yet. Let's try it one more time. And there we go. You can see that it's been updated. So that's how you set up for No IP. Let's do one more type of provider. So we're going to do Cloudflare. I am logged into Cloudflare, and I have a domain here. It's ddns-al.uk that I've purchased. You can use any domain on here that you own with Cloudflare. So what you do to set this up is you have to set up an API key that our client can use to update the DNS zone. And so in order to do that, you have to go down here to manage account, and under account API tokens, you create a token. And you know, you can use API tokens for all sorts of things with Cloudflare. It's really, you know, something that's really cool about Cloudflare is you can give very specific granularity to a set of credentials that you use. So in this case, we only want this token to be able to edit DNS even on a specific zone, right? So I can say I only want this token to be able to update host names on a specific domain. So that's what I'm going to do. You can do IP address filtering, set how long the token lasts. We're just going to go ahead and create it. Okay, so here's the token. Now with Cloudflare, it's a little bit weird. You have to enter bearer as the username when you enter that. So we're going to go ahead and delete our DNS client for no IP, and then we're going to create our client for Cloudflare. Okay, so the password is going to be that API key. The username is going to be bearer. And the other thing that's a little bit weird about Cloudflare is you have to put, instead of like the actual host name, you put the host name, so Route10 speeds. The other thing is we'll have to make sure that you create the host name first. So you can't update a host name that doesn't exist. So we're going to go home, go to our domain, go to our DNS records, and then I already have this host name created. But if you don't have it created, it will not update. So just so you know, and you know, each DNS provider is different. Some of them will create it automatically, some won't. It just kind of depends on which provider you're working with. So in this case, I already have the host name set up. And for Cloudflare, instead of putting dot, you actually need to put at ddns-al.uk. Okay, so instead of a dot, which is what you would expect normally, you put an at. That's just how they do it. And as long as you know that, it's fine. So we're gonna go ahead and save this. And so the Route10 is now configuring that IP address, that resolution for route10speeds.ddns-al.uk to point to the IP address of the WAN interface. So it should be 172.9.0.62. And I'm going to go ahead and do the same thing here. I'm going to query the name server directly because it gets updated immediately. And there you go. You can see that it is 172.9.0.62. If I go into here, yeah, obviously it's there. Now I'm going to use the public WAN IP address, just like we did with no IP. Turn that on, hit save, and now it's going to register my publicly accessible IP address instead of the IP address on the WAN interface. And we'll see how quickly this goes. Yep, there it is, pretty fast. You can see that it's updated in DNS. You can see that it's updated in the DNS records here. And there you go. So we support dozens of different DNS providers. So pretty much anything that is available out there, we support. There are some quirks, obviously, and we are improving our documentation as we go. For example, with Cloudflare, you have to use the hostname at domain. You have to use bearer for the username. Sometimes, like for example, no IP will tell you that you need to use all.ddns.net or something like that for the domain, when in actuality you use the actual host name that you're trying to set up. So even if they tell you to use a certain host name that seems like a globally, one that everybody would use, usually you'll want to use the actual host name that you're registering and checking instead. So little quirks here and there with each provider. So if you have any comments or providers that you would like to update or add any notes to here, we'd love to hear that. If you have any other feedback or anything like that, come join us on our forums, forum.alta.inc. And thank you very much for watching.